Hello everyone. Today I'm going to make alasandi kalu palya and rasam for lunch. I kept this for soaking overnight, adding some more water to it and keeping it for pressure cooking. Alasandi kalu, generally known as cowpeas, goes well with chapati, roti or rice. Counting the divine's infinite blessings and being grateful to him makes our life so beautiful. Isn't it? Getting the privilege of serving our family is also a blessing indeed. Here I'm adding some coconut and green chilies and grinding it to make tokku for the palya. By the time pressure is released from the cooker, I take a pan, then add some oil and adding the ingredients for seasoning like mustard, jeera, curry leaves. After they splutter, we can also add some peeled garlic cloves, which adds to great taste, but I missed here to add garlic. So after seasoning, I'm adding chopped onion directly and giving it a good mix, leaving it for few minutes to fry, keeping it on sim. On the other side, as the pressure is released, I open the cooker. The alasandi kalu is cooked so well, turned out soft as I allowed it to cook for 3 whistles. As the onion turns golden brown, I strain out water from alasandi kalu and use this water to make rasam. We call it as kattu saru. Nothing goes waste here, utilizing everything to the fullest. Now adding alasandi kalu to the pan, leaving behind a handful of alasandi to add it to rasam. Now adding the grinded tokku, then a pinch of turmeric and required amount of salt. Giving it a good mix, the alasandi kalu palya is ready. This is rich in protein and highly nutritious and very healthy. Also tastes very great. It's a challenging thing for every woman to decide what to make every day. So here it is. Once in a while, you can definitely make this healthy dish. Now, I'm going to make rasam with the strained water. Here, taking a vessel, then adding some oil, then the regular seasoning, mustard, jeera, curry leaves, a pinch of hing, and then chopped tomato. Mixing it for few seconds and then adding in the strained water, also called as alasandi kattu. Then adding some more water to get the rasam consistency. Then smashing the alasandi that I had preserved for rasam, then a pinch of turmeric, tamarind paste, little red chili powder, then rasam powder, then a small piece of jaggery, then leaving it to boil for 10 minutes on low flame. In the meantime, I'm going to get the clothes that I had put for drying. Prior planning can help us manage our time effectively. If we take a moment in the mornings to outline our tasks for the day, including time for breaks and leisure activities, then our day goes smooth and productive. If we plan well, we also get ample time for our own hobbies too. Yes, today's my plan is to make ladybugs using the coconut shells. So, quickly finishing off all my daily chores and making time for my hobby. Ladybugs, also called as ladybirds, are not found here generally. We have rarely seen them in real, but we have seen the pictures and they look so lovely and attractive, isn't it? Here, I've preserved some coconut shells to make this craft. I've used some sandpaper to polish the coconut shells, making it clean and clear by removing the coir. I'm using a thick black marker pen and red color acrylic paint. Ladybugs are usually very small, having round or oval dome-shaped bodies, just like these coconut shells. So I chose them, and they generally have black spots over red shining surface. After painting them, I took black color wax crayon and colored the front part of the shell, as the black paint that I had has gone dry. Next, I'm using some glitter marker pens to make the eyes. Then I'm using some black color bindis to make spots over them. They are known for their vibrant colors and distinctive spots. While I was browsing, I found that ladybugs are not only cute, but they are beneficial insects too. Having them in the garden, one can easily get rid of aphids and other pests, as they act as natural predators. And one more interesting fact that I learnt is, ladybug is considered as a symbol of good luck in many cultures. And in some countries, ladybugs are often associated with good fortune, particularly in the matters of love and relationships. Whereas in India, ladybugs are seen as source of happiness and prosperity. They are believed to bring blessings to the households they visit. Therefore, I felt so happy to make them and keep them at home. Now, I'm going to keep them near some potted plants and enjoy their view in my balcony. Squeezing in some time for my interests and hobbies in between the daily chores will just boost my energy. Sprinkling some creativity, adding a touch of beauty, uplifting the appearance of the balcony here. Signing off for now. Thank you for watching my video. For more videos, stay tuned.